Okay, hello everyone. You already introduced me. My name is Mayank, working in Oracle MySQL team. And today I'll be talking about MySQL Performance Schema. Before I go further, am I audible to the last bench?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So this is a safe harbor statement which states whatever I'm presenting over here is for informational purpose. You guys should not make any purchase decision based on that. Right. So this is the agenda for the today's talk. I'll talk about need and design of performance schema. I'll start from why do we need performance schema at all. Then I'll talk about the instruments and instrumentation points which we have in performance schema. I'll talk about the statistics tables where we store the statistical information. And then I'll take few use cases to explain how we can use performance schema to diagnose real world problems. And then we have released MySQL 5.7, which was GA'd in 2015. I'll talk about what new we have introduced there, and then currently we are working on MySQL 8.0. So we have one DMR released. I'll talk about what we have there as far as performance schema is concerned. Okay, so let's talk about need. So the question comes, why do we need performance schema at all? So in MySQL, there are several MySQL users. So there could be an end user who might think, why my session is stuck. There could be an application developer who might think, why my application is running so slow, and a DBA might think, why this particular table is so hot, and so on. So to answer all these questions, performance schema comes into picture. So if you ask me to define performance schema, I would say performance schema is a mechanism to give user an insight of what is happening behind the scene when MySQL Server is running. So we introduced performance schema in MySQL 5.5. We introduced a new storage engine, which is called performance schema, and a new database was introduced, that is performance_schema, and we introduced a lot of tables in this database, and these are the tables where we store all the statistical information of running MySQL Server. The data which we store in these tables is not persistent, so it's in-memory data. So once the server is stopped, the data is gone. And the best part is we provided an SQL interface to the statistical data, so you can fire your SQL queries to see the data which is collected by the performance schema. Okay, before I go further, how many of you heard about performance schema? Apart from MySQL users. Yeah, I mean Oracle. Okay, wow. So let me explain you how this performance schema works in real world. So there are two portions of performance schema. There is one part where we collect the statistics. There's another part where we report the statistics. So the first part where we collect the statistics looks like this. So we have a MySQL server running. In the MySQL server source code, we have different code points, which we call hooks or instrumentation points. When the server is running and the control comes to these points, the control is transferred to performance schema. And we collect the runtime statistics data and then store them into performance schema internal buffers. So that's the bird's eye view how the statistics collection is happening. Now, if suppose a user wants to see some statistical information, he can simply fire queries on performance schema tables. Then this query will be passed and executed, and the data will be fetched from this internal buffers and presented to the user in performance schema tables. So that's the overall design. Let's talk about the instruments and instrumentation. So what are the instruments? So instruments are the name which we give to activities which we monitor in MySQL Server execution. So in MySQL Server executes, there are multiple activities which happens behind the scene. So to uniquely identify those activities, we have given them some name, that is called instrument. And how these instruments looks like, they are the tree-like structure. Different parts are separated by forward slash. And as we move from left to right, we go from generic to more specific things. Let me take an example to explain. So these are the two instruments, and the first one is wait/io/file/mysm/log. So first one says this is a wait instrument. Now there could be multiple kind of wait instruments. So what kind of wait it is? It's an IO wait instrument. Now there could be multiple IO, could be an IO on table, IO on file. So this is an IO on file, and which file? This is a mysm log file. So this is an instrument. Now another instrument is statement/sql/select. So more generic thing is statement. So statement could be an SQL statement, could be command statement. So it's an SQL statement. Now SQL statement could be insert, delete, update, select. So this is a select statement. So this is uniquely identifying an activity which is a select activity. In MySQL 5.7, we have 1,000 plus instruments. That is, we are instrumenting 1,000 plus activities when MySQL Server runs. And all those activities or all those instruments are listed into a table which is called setup instruments. Now let's have a look at this table, setup instrument. This is how this table looks like. It has three columns. The first one states the name of the instrument. The second one says whether this instrument is enabled or not. And the third one says time. So if this instrument is enabled, then only performance schema will collect statistics for this instrument. And if it is time, then only it will collect the timing information of this instrument. So for example, the very first instrument is statement slash SQL slash select. So I say enabled is equal to yes and timed is equal to yes. So when MySQL Server runs, performance schema will collect the statistics for this statement and collect the timing information as well. But for the second instrument, which is create table, I said enabled is equal to yes, but timed is equal to no. So I want to see the statistics of create table, but I don't want to see the timing information. And similarly for create DB, I don't want anything to be collected for this instrument. And the best part is these things are configurable at runtime. So you don't have to restart your server just to modify your statistics collection information. Yeah.
Directly update with this table.
Yes,
then
you can.
Will you stop it? Or enable it or disable it?
Yes, you can do that. So as soon as you say this is disabled, performance will stop collecting information for that instrument. Right. So now let's talk about the statistics table which we have in performance schema. So there are many tables. So these are the tables using which you can tune performance schema, what to collect, how to collect, and then you can also, these are the tables where we store the data of statistics. The first one is setup tables. Like we have setup instruments table, I showed in the previous slide. You can say which instruments to be enabled or disabled. We have setup actors table. In this table, you can specifically say for which user you want to have statistics to be collected. Now we have setup objects table, so you can specifically say for what all objects you want to have the statistic information to be collected. Like you can specify the table itself. For this table only, I want to have the statistics. Or for this stored procedure, I want to have the statistics to be collected. Similarly, we have consumers table, we have timers tables. I mean, you can specify you want information in picoseconds or microseconds or nanoseconds. You can do that. Then we have events table. So when MySQL Server runs and a query is executed, there are multiple events which happens. So first of all, a transaction starts. So this query belongs to a transaction. Then this query is a statement which executes. When this statement executes, it goes through different stages like opening table, closing table, sending data, etc. So these are the stages. And each and every stage goes through different waits event. It is waiting for a mutex, or waiting for a read-write operation, all those things. And then if at all it is not doing anything, it's an idle event. So we monitor all these events in performance schema. Then we have instances table. So we have multiple mutexes, read-write logs, files, sockets, and condition instances, condition variables in MySQL Server source code. We monitor that as well. Then we have log table information. We have information about metadata logs. We have information about the table handles, which are locked or unlocked, and the queries performed. Then we have tables for connection attributes as well. The type of connection is the socket connection or the TCP/IP connection. This thing we introduced, which is replication summary table. So earlier you used to do show slave status to get the replication information. Now all of this information has been ported here in replication summary tables, categorized logically. Then we have, you used to do the show variables, show status command. All this information has been ported in performance schema, in system variables table, status variables table. And then there are miscellaneous tables, other tables as well. So these are the tables which we have. And the biggest thing which we have in performance schema, that is the summary tables. So these are the individual events. Now we have summary tables, which summarizes this information and give us consolidated output. So we have summary tables for events, like summary for statements, stages, weights. We have summary for memory allocation or deallocation. We have summary for file I/O, table I/O, etc., sockets and connection. And the good thing is this summary is also categorized based on different factors. Like we have summary by global overall on the system, summary by thread, for a specific thread, how many statements have been executed, summary by a user or by a host, or the combination of user and host, that is account, and summary by digest, that is for statements only. Let's see what do we get from performance schema. So let's take an example. So as I said, we have the setup instruments table where we store all the instruments or activities which we monitor. Let's say I said update performance schema, setup instruments, set enabled is equal to yes, and timed is equal to yes. So I want to monitor all the activities and I want timing information of all the activities. Let's say I did that. Then I connected two sessions to running MySQL Server. Session 1, let's say, is thread ID 24 and thread ID 25, session 2. And from session 1, I did this. I started transaction 3 times, inserted, this is a very simple use case. Inserted 3 values and then I did a select star. That's all I did from session 1. From session 2, I started transaction, did 2 insertion. That's all I did from session 2. Before I go to the next slide, just keep in mind, there are 3 insert done here, session 1, and 2 insert done here. And the last statement executed from here is select star, and from there it's a commit. Okay, so this is what I know we have done. Let's see performance schema is able to tell me these things. So in performance schema, we have a table called event statement current. So this table gives me the information about the last statement executed by any thread. So in my example, there were 2 threads, 24 and 25. The last statement executed by 24 is a select statement. And then last statement executed by thread 25 is a commit statement. This is the time which was taken to execute this statement, and this is the time taken to execute this commit statement. Okay, so number of rows sent, and if at all there's a table scan, or if at all there's an ending index used or not. Okay, so I got the information about the current statement. Now, how about if I want to know how many statements have been executed by a thread? Then comes the summary. Then summary tables comes into the picture. So we have the summary table which summarizes execution of statement based on thread. So here I can see there is a thread ID 24, which for the insert statement, the count is 3. So that means thread ID 24 has executed 3 insert statements. Total time for this insert statement is this much. Similarly, for thread ID 25, there are 2 insert statements and time taken is this much. So I got the recent statement, I got the statement by thread. Now how about if I want to know overall on the system, doesn't matter from which thread they are coming from, how many statements are executed and what are their characteristics. So I have this summary global by event name. So here I see overall on this system there are 5 insert statement executed and 5 commit statement executed. The time taken for insert statement is this much and for commit statement is this much. So I can see overall the system how many statements are being executed, right? Now let's take the use case. So suppose I have a use case in which there are multiple queries running on MySQL Server, and there are a few queries who are taking a lot of time to complete, and I want to know what are those queries. So can I do this with performance schema? Let's see. So in performance schema we have a table event statement history. This table consists the historical statistics of statement executed. So I say, give me all those statements who are taking time greater than X. Let's say X is my threshold. And I get this information. So it tells me, so there is a thread ID 25 who is doing a select statement, and that is this is the statement X, which is taking time more than X. Okay, so I found out the query, which is performing slow. Anything else can I get from performance schema? I get this information. So select scan is equal to 1. So for this query, a full table scan has been executed. No index used is equal to 1. So index has not been used for this particular query. So if at all I can introduce an index for this query, the performance will be better. Right. Let's take the use case 2. So several statements are running on MySQL Server and few of them are giving errors. So I have this table, event statement summary by digest, which give me information of the statements categorized based on digest. Digest is a normalized form of a statement. So if I query this table, I get this information. So it says for this digest text, that is a normalized form of a statement, it has been executed 1725 times. And out of those 1725 times, it has given error. So it has never executed successfully, right? And I also get the information when was the first time this statement was executed and when was the last time it is executed. So I need to look into this statement, what is happening, right? Let's take a use case 3. So I am a MySQL developer, source code developer, and there is multi-threaded environment I'm working upon, and my session is stuck. So I want to know what is happening behind the scene. I go to performance schema. So as I had event statements current table, which was giving me information about the current statement executed or being executed, we have events wait current table as well, which gives me information about the current wait being executed or is executed on the server by any thread. So I say, let's say my thread is T1. I say, give me information about everything from the waits current table where thread ID is equal to T1. And I get this information that thread T1 is waiting for a mutex, which is mutex A, right? Now thread T1 is waiting for mutex A and it is not getting it. The only thing is it has been acquired by somebody else. Now we go to the mutex instances table where object instance begin is equal to mutex A. And I get from this column locked by thread ID, this mutex A is locked by thread ID T2. So T2 is holding mutex A and not releasing it. That means T2 is also waiting for something else. I again go to the event waits current table and do a select star with thread ID is equal to T2 and so on. So I can keep on going and digging and finally I will find out where exactly the problem lies. I mean, what is the culprit, who is the culprit there? Okay, this is very good thing which we have in performance schema. We have maintained this event hierarchy. So a session could have multiple transactions running. A transaction could have multiple statements inside it. And I said a statement goes through different stages and each and every stage goes through different weights. So this hierarchy is maintained. So you can pick a particular wait event and you can correlate it to the transaction it is coming from. How do we maintain it? Let's see that. So this is what I said. Right. So there are multiple transactions on the server, multiple statements, multiple stage events, waits event. To uniquely identify these events, we have given them an event ID. So using an event ID, we can uniquely identify a wait event or a stage event or a statement or transaction. Now, how do we correlate this wait event to the stage event? So as I said, a stage consists of multiple waits event. So all the waits events who are coming from a specific stage event would have nesting event ID of that stage event. Similarly, all the stage events who are coming from a particular statement would have nesting event ID as an event ID of the statement. And similarly, all the statements which are coming from a specific transaction would have nesting event ID of the event ID of the transaction. So with this hierarchy, I can start from the wait event and go back to the transaction and see from which transaction this wait event is coming from. Right. So the instruments which we have in 5.7, we have a question?
Yeah, how do you assign an event ID to a statement actually?
This is by, I mean, internally. The user don't have to do anything. It is done internally by performance schema.
Okay.
It's a unique ID. These are the instruments which are available in 5.7. We have instruments for IO operation like file IO, table IO or the socket IO. Then we have instrumentation for locking. We have mutexes, read write locks, table locks, metadata locks. We monitor them. Then different events, as I said, transactions, statements, stages, waits, and idle event as well. And stored program, function triggers, events and procedures. And then we also have statistical information categorized by user, host, account, thread, and global. And we also monitor the memory allocation and deallocation performance schema, which is happening in MySQL Server, and many more. In 5.7, which we released in 2015, we added a lot of new instruments. We added information about the user variables, transactions, memory usage, stored program, and prepared statements, MDLs, types of connection, the different stages of InnoDB execution, the application summary tables, and global and session variables and status. Apart from that, we introduced a lot of enhancements as well. The digest size, which was fixed in 5.6, is configurable in 5.7. We can specifically save to collect the historical statement for a particular thread, so there is no need to collect historical statement for all the threads. And then the memory location performance schema, which was fixed before in 5.6, is scalable now. So based on the load, it allocates memory for performance schema buffers. And the memory footprint, we have also reduced. There are a lot of improvements which we have internally in performance schema. So memory utilized for performance schema is less, and many more. So in 5.7 GA, we have 87 tables in performance schema. So these many tables which are storing the statistics of MySQL Server. And we have 1,000 plus instruments. So as I said, 1,000 plus activities which we are monitoring in performance schema. And as in the previous session you heard, sys schema is also introduced in 5.7. So sys schema is a collection of procedures, function, and views. And what are those? So they are the common day-to-day use case scenarios which DBAs are seeing or debugging. What does sys schema do? It takes information from performance schema, it takes information from information schema tables, and do some formatting, create a very good format, and present it to the user. We have received very good feedback about this component which we introduced. Earlier it was known as DS Helper in 5.6. So you guys should go back and give it a try, sys schema. And in MySQL 8.0, we are working upon now. We have released one DMR last year. In performance schema, we introduced indexes on PFS tables. So earlier there was no indexes, it was doing a table scan. Now we have introduced indexes, so specific data, specific rows can fetch. And then we also introduced instrumentation for server errors. So earlier there was no instrumentation for errors, now we have introduced that as well. And there are many more things which we are working upon now. So in future you will see those things. And that's all I have. Any questions?
One.
Yeah.
Is there any chance, for example, in 5.7, there is no indexes on the performance schema. But if I have to run a query to check the performance of the production database, sometimes it's created a load on the DB. Is there any chance I can propagate those performance schema in a replicated environment, on a slave actually, and then run and check the query by running a query on the slave of the production?
So,
is this possible?
On slave, you have to turn on performance schema.
That will tell the performance of the slave.
On the slave, yeah, on the slave only.
But I want to check actually a performance of the master from the slave.
I don't think so. It can do. It cannot.
I don't know, look a bit fishy.
Yeah.
But, means my plan is that I don't want to create a load on the production environment.
I mean, the performance schema is specific to an instance. It gives you information about that instance.
Yes, this one.
Yeah.
But it is a different engine. How much load does it put on the InnoDB just to look, read the performance schema tables?
You don't really put any load.
Yeah. So the engine that is so we talked about this pluggable engines in MySQL. So performance schema is actually a separate engine.
Yes.
So it is not really putting that much load on your InnoDB. So your InnoDB data performance should not be affected that much. It's only the other part of my
that is the thing which we are talking about yesterday actually. What my observation is that in MySQL, when any bad query is running or heavy query is running from any session, that will and other session will get impacted. This is the problem. This is at least I
but those that. Queries would not be performance schema, I guess.
In my case, that was normally not from the performance schema, but sometimes if it's from the performance schema, if I run a query, bad query on a performance schema which is fetching so much data, the other users will get the impact.
First of all, performance schema queries does not fetch data from the hard disk, and that's all in-memory data. So there's
so
no IO operation involved. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so unless it's sending the data, a lot of data over the network, and that's the issue, then. Yeah, I've never seen
if
you're in the
performance, that is the problem.
It's your network pipe.
could be.
And we don't recommend using SANs and NASs over the smaller net. It's never.
We are not using actually SAN and NAS, we are only 100% RDS based specifically. And RDS has its own limitation, it's an AWS service on top of MySQL.
But you need the data pipeline. There's somewhere might be.
Yeah, of course, they have implemented some restriction, of course, on the network layer.
So that could be a problem.
And I guess there was a question in the morning about can we do profiling of queries in MySQL? So we can do it using performance schema. I mean, we can see for a specific query how much time this query is spending in a specific stage. That information we can get from performance schema, from the stage instrumentation. So the thing which you had, one query is running very long and it is impacting other queries. So you can run this stage instrumentation on other queries and see where they are actually waiting for.
Hmm.
Which particular stage they are waiting a lot.
Getting most time. Yes.
And so add to that, in the SWIS schema, there's actually a procedure that can do that profiling and output into the dot format that is produced by, it's called graphics. So create a graph of the profiling with using the hierarchy. So you can see running this statement, go through these stages, and it will
function in the SWIS schema.
A procedure in the system. Of course, if there's a lot of instruments that are getting triggered, that graph can be so huge that it's not possible to really see anything, but in smaller cases, it can be really useful.
Okay, one more question is related to maybe a performance thing. Is there any chance I can mark my query by some flag? So I can track it, that particular query in performance schema or system schema. For example, this query is coming from a specifically part of my source code for some transaction. So I can track what is the performance of that particular query while curing the performance schema. Is this anything which is possible?
So you can specifically say for this particular user, for this particular host, I want to get the instrument statistics for. You can specifically say, and for those things, you can specifically see the statistics of each and every query. So let's say I say from Mayank, which is coming from xyz.com, instrument everything from this and forget about all other users. The performance schema will not consider all other users and collect the statistics for this particular.
This is the thing which you already mentioned, that for one particular session or one particular thing you can, but my exact question is to track particular query actually. For example, I flag a query with some name. For example, that's like we are introducing a hints in the query. I just made some comment in it. It's coming from this transaction, part of my source code, my Java code, and then I track that particular query.
Java code? Performance schema cannot tell me anything about the application.
The query, actually, the SQL statements coming from a Java source code.
But you can say the select on this table, whenever a select is done on this table, that query I want. That much you can do. An update on this table from this user, from this machine, that will be.
I think the whole query text is also available.
It is available.
Can you use light and match the pattern of the main query?
Or just before the query, you enable the instrumentation and just after the query disable. So only that query will be logged.
Any more questions? Okay, round of applause.